we all ended last year and went into the new year with some heavy news for folks that are in and around the hip hop scene, especially, you know, the independent underground movements. We were informed of passing of Mr. MF Doom, and you know, he's a artist who probably made my favorite rap music. If I'm just sitting here as my own human being, just being honest. So like it's hit me pretty weird. Like, you know, your favorite, the person who makes your, you know, favorite, most inspiring, most valuable work is like no longer with you. It's like it's a real stunner, man. But how have you been doing?
That one hurt. That, you know, finding that out New Year's Eve, and then finding out that he had been gone for several months, which is kind of just exactly as legendary as only he could
pull it like that.
Only him. Only him. And there's always a little thought in the back of your head where you're just like, he's like the one dude. And I'm going to just say it because everyone's thinking it. Dude who I would not, he's the only dude I would not be like completely 100% surprised if he just popped back up. You know what I mean? Like, he's just such a legend. He's just such a mysterious figure. And he already emerged, you know, as a new person. Yeah. There aren't too many people that have had multiple careers and then gain audiences that people don't even really know that they had something before that. Doom for me was Zev Love X.
A special appearance by KMD's Zev Love X. A gas face. Can either be a smile or a smirk when a pair's a monkey wrist to work one's clockwork. Perkin is built to the rim of my cup. Don't tempt me, you're empty. So fill her up is a.
And when I heard the original Doom, the MF Doom shit drop on Fondling, and obviously Bobito was my man, it was just so fucking raw. It was never before had I ever seen anybody not only just have like a second name, but also be like a second person, you know? Right. Like, this dude had gone through some shit and emerged.
He changed.
As a mythical character.
It go like, I hold mics, like niggas hold their girls tight. But I ain't at the hub, probably your Acura Pearl White. The hook or not, as many times I'm split it. To be specific, more times the dimes in the business.
And when you broke it was so fucking, it was just, it wasn't what you had ever heard from him. And very quickly, you were just like, this is a totally different artist. This is a completely different person, you know, in a lot of ways. Yeah, no, I'm sad about this. I hadn't seen Doom. And I think I saw Doom, last time I saw Doom was in Europe. We played a show together in Europe. Yeah. I'm a little speechless, man.
I hear you, dude. You know, because he is the master of reinvention. In fact, like, cause the, you know, the whole thought behind even like this podcast, this show, is to talk to people who've had those different reinventions.
Right.
So he's always been like the ideal guest, but it's just like, am I really going to be able to nail that dude down? That was always my first thought was like, nah, that seems impossible. But you're right. Like, to the point where, when I got the news too, man, I had to send an email to somebody who I know would actually know. Like, I needed a confirmation.
Right.
Because, you know what I'm saying? Because you're saying, it's not above him. He didn't seem to be above some mass trickeration.
Nah, he was
on that level.
He was on some Andy Kaufman shit. Like, he was on some rap Andy Kaufman shit. Like, for sure. I mean, we're talking about a guy who would send out people in his mask to do shows. Man. Like, and I remember people being mad at it at the time and me understanding like, okay, I get why you'd be mad. But at the same time, can we just step back here and look, you know what I mean? Can we just step back and just assume that it's 2 or 3 years have gone by, maybe even a decade has gone by and you're over, you're hurt. And then can you just look at it historically and just admit that that's, that's the illest shit in the legendary. World. You know, like, come on, man. Legendary. Like, legendary. It was immediately legendary.
Well, yeah, I was at one of those shows. I was at one in Cali, where it was a Doom posture.
Right.
And just because I'd seen him once in real life, like, I knew immediately, like, oh, we got. Yeah. And it did hurt, man. It was like a New Year's Eve show out here in LA. It was like a really, really big deal. And everybody was pissed. And you know, I had that moment of like, damn, I'm legit mad at dude for like not thinking that, you know, that we're important to show up for or whatever. Right. But this is before I knew the circumstances or before anything. And I went from being that mad to like, you know, it wasn't too long later. I'm right back into, this is my favorite dude.
Yeah. It's a severe blow to the music world. That's how I look at it. I'm affected, and I didn't even really know him like that. I just know him. You know what I mean? Like, mm-hmm. I could only imagine that there are some really broken hearts out there. But for the music world, it is legitimately a huge loss for the writing world. And I don't just mean the rap world, you know, and I don't just mean lyric writing. I mean, like, human writing. You know, like, the world lost an important writer.
That's really real. Whew, all right, man.
So feel free to cut this shit off anytime you want, because now I'm depressed. The first time I really hung out with Doom was for our video shoot for NM Burners, Company Flow.
Oh, shit. Okay.
Yeah, he just rolled by, man. We were shooting at the Transit Museum in Brooklyn, and he rolled by at like 7 a.m. When we all got there. I had reached out, like, you know, we had spoken or something, and I was like, yeah, you should come via this video. And he fucking was there like 7 a.m. And that was the first time we hung. He's in that video. A lot of people don't know that he's in that video as MF Doom, but it's because you really can't see him. It's like a flicker. Like, the dude, he's kind of hood up and like, it's a flicker, but he's in that. But yeah, that was the first time we hung out. And I was very blessed to hang out a handful more times throughout our lives. I did some work with him and a little bit. He was on one of my beats.
This one goes out to my brother Cucumber, who cut it up like a lumberjack do lumber. It's no cover, never. Drink tickets forever. Still, if it spill or your mink or your sickest lover, my mistake. You kept it all straight. They open your cake faster than the time the rhyma takes, comma. Rhyma who go over where the chorus is at, comma. The flow go comma, the more it's cat.
So over the years, we just bumped into him, you know, he was always just the friendliest dude and just the nicest guy. And,
you know, I'll be taking a lot of it going forward, just trying to remember his approach and remember who he was and like really hold on to that. And so I never forget, you know what I'm saying? And big up to his family, his legacy. Just, yeah. You know, before we got into the subject of the episode, man, I just wanted to take a little bit of time, especially given that you knew the man, to, you know, just say a few words about him. So, you know, rest in peace, rest in power, all that good flowery shit.
For sure.
Stony Island Audio.